Coppin State University in West Baltimore began as the Colored Training School, a one-year training program for the preparation of colored teachers. Established December 18, 1900, Coppin was housed with the Colored High School, now known as Frederick Douglass High School. Coppin had relocated to several shared spaces before moving to its present-day location, spanning 38 acres with North Avenue as its main artery. In 1926, Coppin took the name Fanny Jackson Coppin Normal School. A phenomenal woman, Fanny Jackson Coppin was born enslaved, but excelled to become the second African-American woman in the United States to ever graduate from college, and the first African-American to become a superintendent of a school district. Fostering pride in the colored community, Coppin's student body grew from a small, select group of Baltimore's colored elite to hundreds of students prepared to serve Baltimore as supervisors, principals, and teachers, many of whom became history's first. Bishop Lee Robinson, first black police commissioner of Baltimore City. Verda Welcome, first black woman to become a state senator in the country. Sam Davis Jr., first black managing editor of the Baltimore Sun in its near 200-year history. Stephanie Reddy, first woman to be a courtside NBA sports analyst. Margaret Peggy Murphy, first black woman to chair the Baltimore City Legislative Delegation. Mary Carter Smith was a founding member of Big Brothers Big Sisters America. Samuel H. Wilson established the Arena Players, the oldest black community theater in the country, which first debuted at Coppin's Connor Hall, named after the university's first president, Dr. Miles W. Connor. Coppin's history became rooted in activism, including the 1960s Coppin State Teachers College lunch counter sit-ins and student government boycotts, to the 1970s establishment of community service programs under the leadership of Coppin's longest-serving president, Dr. Calvin W. Burnett. The university heightened its focus on prison reform, community recreation, the aged and drug abuse programs, becoming the only HBCU in the nation to offer a graduate degree in vocational rehabilitation counseling. After the closing of Provident Hospital, Coppin started its renowned nursing program. Coppin's natural progression sees the university transform from a teacher training institution to that of an urban, comprehensive liberal arts institution. Awarding its first degree outside of the field of education, Coppin's first Bachelor of Arts degree was conferred in 1967. Today, designated with full university status, Coppin enjoys four colleges in arts, sciences and education, behavioral and social sciences, business and health professions, a graduate studies program, and a PhD in nursing, and named its first woman president in 2015, Dr. Maria Thompson. Coppin graduates remain Coppin proud, succeeding over and over again and writing on the encouraging words of its namesake.
Man, I got this right. My MX in my bag. You know what I've been tagged. Man, I got this right. Man, I got this right.